Well, it's been a task. It's been a year, a decade in the making, really. They've found what is supposedly the explorer ship Le Griffon, which is a French explorer ship. And they spent well over a decade, I think, in courts, federal courts. They followed the laws on arresting it to be able to move forward working with French officials. But the state jumped in and really made it difficult for anybody to do anything in the Great Lakes as far as exploration, not just this group, but any group. And I got involved with them researching the weather because of my background in forensic meteorology. They asked me to go back and recreate the weather at that time, so I did it. And that's how I got involved with it, and I was really intrigued in their case or situation, because by rights, by law, this ship, which hasn't been truly identified yet, they believe it is, and that's part of the work that's going to be moving forward. It's embedded in the bottomlands. So by state law, state rights, it belongs to the people of the state of Michigan, held in perpetuity. Once it's positively identified, and that's what they're going to be going out and doing here in the next couple of weeks, if it truly is the Le Griffon shipwreck, then transfer of ownership would go to France, because they would claim ownership, and then, of course, it would be between France, the state of Michigan, and the Explorer group on how to move forward on any educational level or to recover the artifacts. It would be a public-private partnership. But there was a few state officials within the state of Michigan that were trying to shift the exploration to NOAA up in Alpena. And frankly, since the state has rights to it, it should be the state's decision on how to move forward. And after much work and trying to raise the awareness of what the state truly owns in the bottomlands, I'm glad that the DNR has finally approved the permit for exploration. And all they're going to do is go down and do a test excavation, which is they're going to dig a small hole in a few areas to determine if it truly is the Le Griffon.
If it is, Representative McMaster has called it the Holy Grail of Great Lakes shipwrecks. And when we get back in 60 seconds, we'll find out how far down it is and where it is, if it is, in fact, Le Griffon. Stay with us.